Hello and welcome. My name is Crystal and I want to welcome you to Ridgeline's Night of Worship. We are the Weber's home church and we want to welcome you, so feel free to come in the middle. We're going to dance and sing and praise to God.
Thank you. We're standing on your goodness tonight and nothing else, Lord. We look to you, we worship you this evening, champion.
Thank you. All things are possible.
stronghold will crumble. I hear the chains within. Oh God of revival.
Chains hit the ground. Oh God of revival. Thank you.
tonight. God, we are so thankful that you are our anchor when the storms are here, that you are a comfort, and that you are near to the brokenhearted. We just thank you for that. And I just pray that when peace would settle right now in the name of Jesus and comfort. Well, again, I want to welcome you guys to Ridgeline's Night of Worship. And if you guys are thirsty, we have free water over here to your right. And Pastor Nathan is just going to bring a quick word, so I hope you enjoy.
Pastor Nathan, that's so formal, it's my wife. But I make her call me that around the house, so I guess that's what I get, right? Just kidding. All right. Well, good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. Man, what a blessing. Jennifer, we're so honored to be here. We're so happy. And for those of you who don't kind of know the story or haven't kind of figured out how this all came about, a couple of weeks ago, Jennifer asked us as her church, as her home church, hey, will you guys come out and do a night of worship? And, you know, in my mind, you know, the way that Eric had been declining and with because of brain cancer and all of that, I thought this is probably going to be his last church service with Ridgeline. And I know that they've been watching online every Sunday and all of that, but we would be so honored just to come out and do it. And of course, as I assume that all of you know, that Monday, 12:16 p.m. in the afternoon, right around noon, Eric passed away. Eric passed away. And what I, of course, dealt with a lot of emotions when it comes to this, as I'm sure, you know, like, not in comparison even to what the family dealt with, but you know, one of the things that I took confidence in is that I remember several, it's probably a little over a year ago, when Eric was in our church service on Sunday morning, and I talked about Jesus Christ becoming the Lord and the Savior of his life. And I remember him raising his hand, and then I remember kind of beginning to watch the process of his life change. And those that were close to him beginning to see this change as he began to live differently, understanding that Jesus Christ and Jesus Christ alone was his Lord and Savior. Yes. It wasn't all of his accomplishments, although there were so many. Such a brilliant guy, accomplished and achieved so much throughout his life. He was, at one point in his life, he was the youngest person to ever do what he was doing in the industry of medical health things that I don't understand. Of course, raised, married a beautiful woman, raised wonderful kids.